Deuteronomy chapter 34. Moshe ascended from the plains of Moab to Mount Nebo, to the summit of Pisgah, across from Jericho. There Adonai showed him all the land, Gilead as far as Dan, all Naphtali, the land of Ephraim and Manasseh, the land of Yehuda, all the way to the sea beyond, the Negev and the plain, including the valley where Jericho, the city of date palms, is, as far away as Sor. Adonai said to him, This is the land concerning which I swore to Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. I will give it to your descendants. I have let you see it with your eyes, but you will not cross over there. So Moshe, the servant of Adonai, died there in the land of Moab, as Adonai had said. He was buried in the valley across from Beit Peor in the land of Moab, but to this day no one knows where his grave is. Moshe was 120 years old when he died, with eyes undimmed and vigor undiminished. The people of Israel mourned Moshe on the plains of Moab for 30 days. After this, the days of crying and mourning for Moshe ended. Yehoshua, the son of Nun, was full of the spirit of wisdom, for Moshe had laid his hands on him, and the people of Israel heeded him and did what Adonai had ordered Moshe. Since that time, there has not arisen in Israel a prophet like Moshe, whom Adonai knew face to face. What signs and wonders Adonai sent him to perform in the land of Egypt upon Pharaoh, all his servants, and all his land. What might was in his hand. What great terror he evoked before the eyes of all Israel.